Hi, I'm Stefan Dalgatz. I'm a senior advisor on climate change at the World Bank Group. Today, I'd like to share with you some of the key data that underpinning the discussions that take place in Glasgow at COP26. Let's start today by examining how people are vulnerable to climate change, and especially extreme events and natural disasters. We're going to look at the number of people dying in climate-related disasters, as well as the economic damages of those events. And on this topic, I have good news and I have bad news. The number of natural disasters and climate extremes has actually increased over the last 50 years by a factor of 4, more or less. But here is the good news. See this yellow line going up and down? It's the number of people dying in natural disasters, and it has been declining by about 70% over the last 50 years. Why has it happened? First, because of development. Richer people are better placed to prepare for disasters and to cope with them. But any development would not do. We also made a lot of progress in weather forecasting, early warning systems, disaster preparedness. For instance, in countries like India, we are now able to evacuate hundreds of thousands of people before a storm hits, which we were not able to do a few decades ago. But there is a very different story when it comes to the economic costs of these disasters. The green line that you see here going up shows you the economic damages from these disasters. And it goes up to hundreds of billions of dollars a year now. This increase also explains why disasters play a key role in keeping people in poverty. We estimate that about 26 million people fall in poverty every year just because of disasters. This increase is linked to an increased intensity and frequency of droughts, heavy rainfall, heat waves. But the main reason is population and economic growth, and especially the growing stock of assets, that's buildings, houses, roads, railroads, and factories that are built in areas exposed to natural disasters. And that still happens because we are not taking into account today's and tomorrow's climate risks in how we decide where and how to invest. Too often, we build new neighborhoods in floodplains, we build new infrastructure with outdated standards or that cannot resist high winds or rainfall. One big challenge for climate action today is to make sure all of what we build is located and designed, taking into account today's risks, but also the risks that climate change is bringing to us. Thanks for watching, and please do check out the other presentations on climate data.